If you are into drugs, or if you can't do without drugs, don't come to the Philippines. Philippines is not for you. Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Dorcas. Thank you for tuning in. If you're a new subscriber, thank you so much. And if you're a returning subscriber, you are the real MVP. I want you to quickly do something. I want you to click on that red button below, that subscribe button. I want you to be subscribed to this channel. I also want you to click on the bell notification so that you can be notified every time I release a new video. And I also want you to like this video, give it a thumbs up, and also let me know your thoughts down below. I'm so encouraged by my last video. I got a lot of comments. I got a lot of message from people. I discovered that a lot of people are really interested in knowing about the Philippines, and a lot of people are also considering coming to the Philippines because of the video I made. That is what prompted me in making this video as quick as possible. Now, I want you guys to not stop commenting. I really appreciate it when I see your comment, because it shows that I am really talking to some people and some people are really interested in what I'm saying. It shows that I am carrying you guys along, and whenever I respond to your comment, I'm always happy. I'm always happy because it is as though we are both sitting together and having a conversation. So you guys don't hesitate to comment on my videos. I really so much appreciate it. So, to the main reason for this video, I'm going to be telling you 10 things that you must know before coming to the Philippines. During my own time, I wish I had someone who told me this, and I wish I got this information. But then I discovered that this information is not well known to people, and you don't come across this on YouTube and everything. So I have decided to make this video for you so that you can know and you can be well guided. So let's go straight into the video. So since I have discovered that a lot of people are really interested in knowing more about the Philippines, I have decided to share with you everything you need to know about the Philippines, from food to study, to accommodation, to their friendliness, to racism. Everything you need to know, I decided to share with you. So let's start with this one. 10 things you need to know before coming to the Philippines. Number one is work. I've had a lot of questions like you that, oh, can I work in the Philippines? Can I study and work in the Philippines? In the Philippines, as a foreign student, you cannot work. It is either you have a work visa or you have a studying visa. And if you have a studying visa, you cannot work in the Philippines. No, all you have to do is to study. But then you can have your own business. You can own your own business, but you cannot work in the Philippines. That is why if you are planning to study in the Philippines, you need to have a sponsor. Yes, because you need allowance, you need money, you need to pay tuition fee, you need to have a sponsor. So my next point, you renew student visa yearly. A lot of foreign students, a lot of international students are victims of this, because they don't know that they have to be renewing their student visa yearly. If you are planning to come to the Philippines, one of the things you need to prioritize is your student visa, the renewal of your student visa. If you don't renew your visa when you're supposed to renew your visa, you get a fine. You incur debts upon yourself. For instance, as of now, rather, to renew your student visa yearly, I think it costs about 135 to 137,000 naira. But when you don't renew your visa when you're supposed to renew that visa, you incur a debt of 500 to 600,000 naira. That is excluding the original amount of money you need to do that visa. Excuse me, please permit the noise that is going on here. One of the disadvantaged Philippines will disgrace you. So the next point, that will be tuition fee. The tuition fee may still be expensive for Nigeria. I assume that we all know that Nigeria currency does not have value here. Naira does not have value here. So Nigerians may still find it difficult a little bit in paying their tuition fee. And you pay tuition fee here by semester. For instance, Kenyans now, they are enjoying here because their currency is greater here. Ghanaians are enjoying here because their currency is greater here. But because our own Naira does not have value here, that is why we still feel like the tuition fees expensive, even though Philippines is one of the cheapest country you can school in. To my next point, that will be scholarship. Philippines schools in the Philippines do not give foreigners scholarship. No matter how brilliant you are, no matter how intelligent you are, they won't give you scholarship. There are a lot of Africans, particularly Nigerians, who are doing very well in their class, who are topping their class, but then they will not give them scholarship. They will acknowledge them, put them in the dean's list and all those kind of things, but then they will never give them scholarship. but they do give their citizen scholarship. I think the reason why they don't give foreigner scholarship is because schools here in the Philippines, they make money from foreigners. So just imagine if the person you are making money from, you are also giving the person scholarship. That means the person will not pay tuition fee. So I don't know, but they don't give foreigner scholarship. So if you are planning to come here, expect to be paying your tuition. So my next point, that will be the tuition fee. As a foreign student, you pay twice the amount of a Philippine citizen. If a Philippine citizen is paying 300K naira per semester to study nursing, you as a foreigner, you will be paying 600K. That is twice that amount. They've added a lot of fees, foreigner fees and everything that made your own tuition fee higher than the citizen's tuition fee. And that is the same way it is for everybody and in every school.
And tuition fee are paid by semester. So you pay tuition fee every semester. But if you have the money to pay yearly, good for you, they won't reject it. In fact, if you have the money to pay for the entire duration of your course, they will not also reject it. Good.
So my next point, making year as a lady here in the Philippines is money consuming. Making year here is not for everybody. If you know that you cannot stand the stress of making year, please lock your year before coming here, or you cut your year. Can you see my own? My own is big on my head like that, and it may use a lot of this before I find solution to it, because making here is very, very money consuming, and because the resources are not available here. For instance, the extension, the wools, the relaxers, everything, they are always shipping them from Nigeria because they don't have them here, and they sell them for a very, very expensive price. So here may be very, very difficult for you here, but if you have your money to spend, good for you.
Those I pity the most are those who use relaxers on the ear, because relaxers are expensive here. And if you know relaxing, you know what is the procedure in relaxing, you have to keep on relaxing your ear continually, as if you are giving the ear sacrifice like that. So if you don't have all those things, please just do something about your ear, because your ear is really going to get damaged, or when you are coming here, you bring a lot of pain.
To my next point, I wish somebody told me this before coming here. And that is, learn a skill before coming to the Philippines. It is very, very important you learn a skill. If it's that you learn how to be barbing men's hair, or learn how to be braiding hair for ladies, just learn a skill, because it's going to help you. You're going to make money by doing all those things here, because there are a lot of Africans here and they make hair. So you can make more money by doing that. So make sure you learn a skill. Even if it is sewing clothes, just learn a skill before coming here, because you will really make money by putting that into practice here. So my next point, that will be citizenship. I get a lot of questions like, oh, can you get Philippine citizenship? My dear, you cannot get Philippine citizenship. If you like marry a Filipina, you cannot get a citizenship. Neither can you own a property here. You can only be given, I think, permanent residence or something. And you cannot own property here. If you want to buy a property here, it has to be done in your wife's name. And if in the future you both divorce, you know the meaning of square one. Square one, that is where you will start from. But no cause for alarm. Filipino ladies don't joke with African guys, especially Nigerian guys. But I don't know why. I don't know what Nigerian guys are doing to them that they don't joke with them. So my next point, that will be the board exam. You can't take board exam in the Philippines. Neither can you get license here in the Philippines. After you finish studying here in the Philippines, you are expected to go back to your country to take the board exam in your country. So that is where you get your license. But you can stay longer in the Philippines if you want. That left to you. To the last but not the least point, if you are into drugs or if you can't do without drugs, don't come to the Philippines. Philippines is not for you. Philippines government don't joke with drugs. Any suspected drug dealer or drug taker or whatever you are doing with drug, they are always killed here. Don't come here to come and commit crime, because you will rot here. And you know that Nigerian government don't care about Nigerians here. So don't come here to commit crime, because nobody will intervene for you here. So guys, that's it for today. I want you to drop your thoughts down below in the comment section. I really appreciate your comments. It shows that I'm really taking you guys along and you guys are really interested in what I'm talking about. I also want you to drop in the comment section if there's any topic you might want me to talk about staying here and studying here in the Philippines. I'm also planning to share my experience with racism here in the Philippines. Yes, I've experienced racism here in the Philippines, but no cause for alarm, because most Filipinos are actually nice people. And if you want me to share that with you, I want you to drop that in the comment section. Tell me that you are interested in knowing more about that, and I will do so. And I really hope you give this video a thumbs up, you share with your friends and family, and you please click on that subscribe button and be subscribed to this channel so that you don't miss out on my interesting videos. And until next time, see you again. Bye.